Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Jives Fishing. So today we are here at Bedok Jetty. Time now is about 8 plus, yeah, just after dark. So the plan for today is to fish until maybe 12, 1 or 2 a.m. ish. We'll see how things go. Okay, but we're going to try something slightly more special because we've been recently catching a lot of eels here. Actually not recently, yeah. Every time we come here we catch a lot of eels. And we heard that they are good bait, okay, for stingray. So we just want to find a use for them because every time we catch them, then sometimes they turn the line and then it just gets stuck and then we have to cut and the eel sometimes doesn't survive. So we are hoping that something must be out there eating the eels. So we're going to try to use them as bait. But in case we don't catch any eels or in case it doesn't work, then we will have live prawn. Yeah, we brought live prawn and we also brought Kelong Sotong. Yeah, so our main target is to find out if anything even eats the eel in the first place. I think so. Okay, I hope so. And yeah, we'll get fishing, update you guys again later. Okay, something on the handline. You.
Everything is
you. Everything is you.
Honestly, this one really feel like you.
Cuckoo.
Not fighting. Like
heavy.
Just.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. It's a fat you. Because there has been pretty quiet, we caught some eels just now, so here they are. Yeah, and we heard that eels are kind of good bait for stingray. Yeah, so we're just gonna try and bait one up.
Pretty smaller one.
Yeah, I think this. But yeah, this looks.
The other one's a bit.
Yeah, you see. Yeah, okay, so anyway, this is an estuarine moray. Okay, usually we don't keep eels. Okay, yeah, because we don't want to eat them. But we heard that they are good bait, so we're just gonna try.
And sometimes also because they tangle up a lot,
yeah.
Not sure whether they can survive, so we just keep them, don't waste them.
So the reason why we don't use it live is because it will like disturb your line, like it will coil around your line, then your line will get destroyed. Yeah, yeah, so we use
a lot
it.
Of knots.
Yeah. So we use it dead. I'm not sure how to hook this. But I'm just gonna try. I think just through the head. Maybe like just like that. Should be okay, right? Should I like no, right? I think yeah, okay. Yeah.
Come on,
I don't, yeah, I also don't think it'll come out. So it's just a nice long U long. So hopefully a big stingray comes and finds this. I honestly don't know if it'll work. We just heard that it might work. Yeah, so anyway, let's cast this out. Since we cast out this eel and it's been sitting there for 45 minutes and yeah, nothing.
I don't know,
probably crabs.
Okay.
Very likely, yeah, the crabs just destroyed it, so we'll check it soon. Maybe replace it with another eel. maybe. Or okay, the bigger ones, I think we'll cut it. Yeah, but we'll check it soon. Maybe about 15 more minutes. Yeah, so we'll update you guys again later. On to some fish, but it's on a small rod. Suspecting it's a grouper or some type of snapper. Yeah, so that one's on a live prawn triple Apollo, size 6 hook, so a very very tiny hook. And what happened was the snoot came out. Yeah, so never happened before, but I will look into it lah. There's something with the rig has to change. Yeah, so anyway, that one was quite sad. It ran out already lah, but the snoot just came out. So too bad we lost the fish. Yeah, so that one's on our live prawn, thankfully. The eel has been pretty quiet. Yeah, so anyway, we'll keep fishing and hopefully the eel will strike something. If not, hopefully our kelong sotong and live prawn will have more takes. Yep, so anyway, keep fishing, update you guys again later. On to something.
This
the... Huh? Yes, dude. Is there? This is the eel, eh? And our surf cast. Oh my god, we surf cast the whole bloody eel.
What is that?
Hey. Wait, what? Oh, the eel. Dude.
Is that it?
The eel is hanging out of his mouth. Oh, eel.
Take it. Oh my god. Look at that.
He tried to eat the
whole eel. Oh my god. Greedy,
eh? End up, didn't get to eat. Alright guys, so here's the grouper. Yeah, okay. This is an orange spotted grouper. So otherwise maybe known as a hatchery cod. Yeah. Hatchery cod. Or I've been at first query this. So anyway, this one is okay, honestly we were on the fence about keeping this because it's kind of almost 30 centimeters, which we think is keeping size, but at the same time it's barely on the dot, maybe it's like 29 or 30 or something around there lah. So in the end we decided to release it, yeah, because we have other fish in our freezer and we don't really like have to keep it lah. Yeah, so anyway we just gonna let it go lah. Hopefully it grows big and yeah, it comes back and you know someone else or us can catch it again.
Just take what we need and
yep. So anyway, thanks for the fight and thanks for being greedy and eating my eel. Hey, hello. Hello. Eat the eel, still want to eat boga. Okay. Yep. Again, beautiful. Oh, bye bye. Didn't even get to. Okay.
Hold on.
Alright, guys, so just now that small grouper ate a pretty long eel. Okay, so I don't think size really is an issue for the eel. Yeah, but I just want to try something different. So I have a piece of. Oh, eel. Please don't throw this around. Oh. Prawn tail. Yeah, so anyway, I chopped the eel into pieces. Yeah, and I think I'm going to handline it down. Again, I'm not too sure how to cast it because we had issues casting, but anyway, this is a handline. I'm just going to like toss it so it doesn't really matter. So I think I can just put it through once. Should I do it? No, I think once is enough. Yeah, honestly. Because this is a good thing about using eel is that they are very strong. So like no matter how you pull, it's not going to come out. Yeah, so I can probably leave this here for quite a while. And casting is not an issue on the hand line. Yeah, so I can just like toss it out. So yeah, this is a piece of eel. I don't know if it's going to work. I'm going to bait a couple of pieces la, on the other hand line. So just hope it works. Okay, like, just for some scent. Now yeah, you can see the guts and stuff. Ew. Okay, yeah.
Actually, the fish will eat it.
Yeah, why I would eat it? I mean, I wouldn't, but it looks
there's
very nice.
No
yeah.
There's no predator for eels. You know what keeps it in check?
Yeah, there has to be something. Maybe we just toss it out lightly, so that you know. Okay. Yep. Alright, guys. So, oh, by the way, we are using a long snoot bottom feeder rig. Yeah. So this is a size 20 hook. Yeah, because we are baiting a eel la, so we don't want the hook to be too small. Yeah, and this is a 80 pound line. Yeah, and a long snoot instead of our usual double polo. Yep. Okay, so as I said, we are going to try a bait treading this eel. Hopefully it reduces the resistance so we can cast a bit further. So I'm just going to go through straight like that. Then maybe we try and wrap it so that it doesn't flap around.
If you want to learn how to tie this long snoot bottom feeder rig, we can check out our old videos.
Yeah.
We have how to tie a polo rig and also a long snoot.
Yep. Okay. So
it's so we just wrap a few rounds. I think it's enough already. The eel should be quite tough.
Oh, this there's blood. Juicy.
So this will be the
probably,
sand.
Yeah, the sand. Yeah, maybe that's why people say it's effective.
That
first.
Yeah.
I realize the bait thread helps to squeeze out the...
Yeah, you're right. Squeeze out some sand.
So anyway, we'll just cast this in and hopefully something takes it. Yep. Woo! Okay. Yeah, so just had a take on this eel hand line. Unfortunately, I don't know how the fish dropped, but it dropped. Yeah,
yeah. Actually I was the one who took, but then I think I didn't set the hook. But it was pretty
right.
Decent, I think more than 1 kilo.
Yeah, it's heavy fish. But right, hand line is don't need to set hook. Once the fish take and it pulls the line right, it should automatically go into the mouth. Yeah. Anyway, we're just gonna rebait it though and try again. Hopefully the fish will stay there, because some fish like snapper that they tend to stay around the same area la. Yeah, so we experienced it before in Pongo with the Ankui. Yeah, the red snapper. Yeah, so we'll try again. I don't think it's a snapper that ate the eel la. Okay, maybe, I don't know. Okay, so we'll try again and
most likely we'll eat something.
Yeah, just try. Hopefully yeah it comes back. Yep. So we'll update you guys again later. Same one.
No lah, this one is bigger.
See? No, I see. Yeah, just now.
Oh. Saying we pull back one, then we come back another one. You can hold it up again.
You really came back?
Yeah, it's about 1 kilo plus.
1 plus, I think 1.1,
1.2.
1.2. I would happily eat this. So nice. Yeah, guys, so practice catch and release. The small ones
catch
really...
and release so the big ones
can. Yeah, so the big ones can grow though. Finally. Nice fish. We just got this nice orange spotted grouper right after you release the previous one. And
the dolphin, right?
Yeah, and I believe it was I believe it's the same fish that ate the first time. Because inside the mouth there's actually two holes. Yeah, there's one on this side where our hook was, and there's a tear actually on this side. Yeah, the membrane of the mouth. So yeah, I think that's probably what happened when it take with a lot of force, then the hook ripped through the membrane. Yeah, that's why the fish actually got loose. Yeah, because there's another hole here and there's a tear. Yeah, unless someone else hooked it before, but I don't think so. Yeah.
So we suspect,
yeah. So we suspect is this one. Look at his stomach.
Oh, but he came back.
Yeah, but he came back. Okay, yeah, so
Assuming
it's the same fish lah. So it's a characteristic of certain fish, I think. Yeah, that once they eat something, sometimes they will hang around. And if they're not that spooked, they might still be around the same area lah. Yeah, so it happened to us before. So I believe it happened again. Okay, I'm not too sure lah. So when we clean this fish, we might find something in his stomach, then we'll know for sure lah. Yep, so anyway, it's a very nice fish. Yeah, definitely going home with us lah. Yep, so we'll keep fishing, update you guys again later.
Okay, so we just caught a
false scorpionfish. Yeah, also big the hook we used to eat. Okay, so yeah, you see for this fish, do beware of all this. Okay, there is a mouth venom inside. Okay, it's not fatal, but it'll be very painful. Okay, same for this spine here. Yeah, as well as the you can see it, see the operculum, the flap, and then there's this like beneath this skin, there's this spine here. Yeah, there. At my pliers there, so you can see the spine beneath this, beneath the flap of skin.
Should I put it back?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, go back.
So it's not a true scorpion fish, but it still can be venomous.
Yeah.
Just be careful.
Okay, guys, so we are back here at Bedok Jetty. Yeah, so this is the next day after yesterday. Yesterday we fished until about 3 a.m. in the morning. Yeah, but there's nothing after that big grouper. So we're back here to try out eel again. Hopefully we catch an eel, okay? Because we don't have any like spare eels. So hopefully we catch one so we can use it as bait. Otherwise, we'll have live prawn and hopefully jig some tamban. Yeah, and at night maybe we'll put some kelong sotong out. Yep, so anyway, we will fish today. Hopefully we get something. Yeah, I'll update you guys again later.
Oyo.
Ooh.
Oyo. Oyo. He cannot two line. That is.
Hello.
He broke someone off. Oh, but this is tough. I think he's screwed. How
Keep all.
Give away? Oh, keep.
No, give away.
Okay, la. Yeah.
Wow, nice one.
Alright, so that was an orange spotted grouper. So the dog damn cute. That was an orange spotted grouper. Unfortunately, we didn't catch any eels so far. So that one was a live prawn. And it ate someone else's line and broke them off. Yeah, so when we brought it up, you can see the spare line coming out. Yeah, so that's we have tamban. That was a frenzy not long ago. And yeah, that's about it. So we'll update you guys again later.
So we just caught
a little fish. Yeah, on a tamban. Look at the hook is almost as big as his head. But they're very greedy. Hmm. Okay. Ayo. Hey. Okay, lizard fish. Go back.
Yeah. So this is our, I think, third eel of the day. It's quite a big one. This is our third eel, right?
Yeah, third.
Yeah, right.
This is a small one. A bit annoying.
Yeah. A bit hard to bait. Sort of very big today, but it's okay, we'll keep them. Chop, probably chop or something. We'll fish them first.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
Okay, so we are baiting up some squid on small hook. Yeah, well, we surf cast one huge eel. I'm not going to touch the surf cast rod anymore, it's standing over there. Yeah, so anyway, all these small hooks are not very suitable for putting an eel on it. Yeah, unless we chop up the eel, but even so, yeah, it's a bit. Yeah,
the eel is too big. Right?
Yeah, the eels are a bit too big today.
And it's very tough, yeah. Can't get through the.
So unless we get a smaller eel, otherwise we're just gonna use sotong for now. Hopefully you get a smaller one, I wanna try. Yeah. So
other two pieces of sotong.
So this is just a
standard double apollo.
Yeah, double apollo. Yeah, size
compared to what we were using yesterday, it was a size 20 long snoot rig. Yeah.
So this is to target smaller fish and stuff. It's not really big game, right?
Okay.
So we'll cast this out.
Right guys, so we've come to the end of our session. Yeah, today was actually very very quiet. There was just one grouper on live prawn and one striped eel-tailed catfish. So the eel on our surf cast was untouched. We caught a few more eels, but they were all like very big. So maybe we'll just keep them and chop them up next time, and hopefully when we have bigger hooks to use them. Yeah, but for today the eel was actually very quiet. Maybe it's like too big, then only the big like stingray or that will come and eat. Otherwise it will just sit there lah. Okay, yeah, but the good thing is that it will sit there, so you know that if nothing takes it, it will just stay there because it's very tough. Yeah, so anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed yourself. Hope to see you guys in the next episode.